Hello and welcome to this series on JMeter beginner tutorial. So this is the 10th session and today we are going to see how to create assertions for a JDBC or a database test plan. Okay, so I have created a video on how to create a database test plan, and this particular session is going to be a continuation of tutorial 6. And in this tutorial I have got a request from Rajvinder, who wanted to know how can I assert the SQL results. So that is exactly what we are going to see in this session, and this is the tutorial that you should be seeing before looking into this particular session. So in case you have not seen the tutorial number 6, please go and first see that, because this is going to be a continuation of tutorial 6. Okay, so let us begin and see. This is our test plan that we already created in the earlier 6th session, where we have configured a JDBC connection and we have a JDBC request. Okay, and the request is select star from student 1, and the result of this request is this particular data. Okay, we are getting select star from student 1, we are fetching all this, we are getting all this result. Okay, now how do I assert the response? How do I assert the result of my query, that I am getting a correct response or not? Okay, so for that we have to add assertions, and I am adding a response assertion. Okay, so let us begin step by step. Step one is add a response assertion. Okay, now see, in response assertion I can do a very quick and crude test by making sure that I am getting some text which should be present in the response. So for example, I want to say that I want to check that I'm getting New Zealand in the response. So I can go to my response assertion and I can say main sample only text response contains, and in pattern to test I can add New Zealand. Okay, so what it's going to do is when I run my test, it is going to see if the response contains this particular text or not. If it does, it will pass it, otherwise it will fail it, right? But see, in case of MySQL response, this is not going to be a very good assertion, because I just don't want to assert that I have New Zealand into my response data, but I also want to check that I'm getting right data at the right position. So I want to check that I'm getting New Zealand in second row in column number 4. Okay, so how to do that? So for that, what I'm going to do is go to JDBC request. Okay, and you see the variable names field here, right? In this variable names I can add variables equal to the amount of columns I'm going to get into my response. So for example, here I'm getting 1, 2, 3, and 4 columns, right? So in my JDBC request variable names I can say a comma b comma c comma d. Okay, now what does this mean is every variable separated by comma will correspond to a column into my response. So A will correspond to column 1, B to column 2, and so on. Okay, so step number 2 is add variable names in JDBC request. Okay, now what about if I want to assert only column A or column 1 and column 3rd? So in that case I will just remove B and D, but I will have the comma here so that to tell JMeter that A is for column 1, then I do not want to store result for column 2, so I am keeping it empty, and then C is for column 3rd. If I just want to assert column 3rd, I can do like this, comma, comma, C. Okay, so in my case, I want to assert column A, B, C, as well as D, all the four columns. Now again, please make sure that this is just a name I am giving to the columns. I can also give column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4. So it depends on you, whatever name you want to give. Okay. Now, going to my response assertion, now I have to select JMeter variable, okay, and in this text box I have to give one of the variables that I just provided to my JDBC request. So for example, I want to assert column 4. Okay, now column 4 means this particular data, country. Okay, now it has India as well as New Zealand in two rows. I want to assert New Zealand, so this is row number 2. So I will say column 4 underscore 2. Now this particular variable call 4 underscore 2 will correspond to this particular data in my response. Okay, so I can say step 3 is add JMeter variable, and also we have to add pattern to test. Now what is pattern to test? This. Okay, so we have already added New Zealand here. So now JMeter will check that in column number 4, row number 2, do we have New Zealand or not? If yes, it will pass, else it will fail it. Okay, now if we run it now, we also need to check the response of our assertion. So I am going to add one more listener here, which is assertion results. Okay, so that I can know what is the result of my assertion. Okay, so now I will remove this and run this again. So step number 4 is add listener assertion results. Okay, so yes, see, now it has passed because it is showing in green, and if I go to my assertion results, yes, there is no failure being recorded here, so that means my assertion has passed. What if I say here I want India? Okay, now see, this should fail because India is in row number 1. Okay, but here I am saying column 4 row number 2 should have India. So if now I run it again, let us see what will be the result. Okay, this will take some time because I am using a publicly available free database. In your case, it will be pretty fast. So please bear with me for a few seconds. We will get the results in some time. So the last request took about 19 seconds. So let us see how much time does this request takes. Yeah, we have got the request, we have got the response now, and see, now it is showing in red. Okay, and if I say, if I expand it, it is saying response assertion false. So test failed, variable call 42 expected to contain India. Okay, if I go to assertion results, so again it is saying test failed, variable call 42 expected to contain India, but actually it contained something else, which was New Zealand. So this failed and it is showing me as failure, right? So this is how we can add assertions to our SQL queries in a JDBC request. So let me add step number 5 as run and validate, which we have already done. So this is how we can create assertions for our JDBC test plan. Hope you like it. Thank you.